Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. This is part 20 of my course, The Practical Guide to Mac Security, brought to you by MacMost's great supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts.
So when it's time to get rid of your Mac, whether you're giving it away, recycling it, selling it, or even giving it to another member of your family, you want to make sure you erase it and reset it completely. You never want to give somebody else your Mac, no matter how much you trust them, with all of your stuff on it. You want to give them a fresh start. It's going to be their Mac, and you also don't want to give them the chance to maybe make a mistake that could affect your files, your things in iCloud, your settings, your accounts online. So to erase your Mac, you basically need to go through a few steps. First, make sure you don't need anything anymore. So say you got a new Mac and you used Migration Assistant to bring everything over to the new Mac. Then don't rush it. Wait at least a few weeks. I usually wait a few months. If I don't need anything off the old Mac during that period of time, then I'm pretty sure that I've gotten everything off of it. Everything is now on the new Mac and there's nothing left on the old one. I just usually have it switched off in the corner somewhere in a closet during that period of time. Another technique you can use is to make a clone onto an external drive of everything on the Mac and just have that around for a while. Hopefully you will never need it and eventually be able to reuse that drive for something else. But in the meantime, you have the safety net of knowing that you've taken all the files from that Mac and stored them on another drive before you get rid of the Mac. Then you want to go through a process of signing out of everything on that Mac. So all of the different accounts. Now, if you don't do this, usually it's not a disaster, but sometimes it could be inconvenient to not have the Mac signed out of a particular account or store or something like that. Then you need to erase the drive completely. And this could be a little tricky. A lot of people make a critical mistake here, and I'll show you that mistake in a minute. Then you want to reinstall Mac OS, because when you erase the drive, there's nothing on that drive anymore. Anybody trying to boot up the Mac will simply get a prompt to install Mac OS, or perhaps nothing at all, depending upon the model. So installing Mac OS will make it so it's very similar to how when you buy a new Mac. But you want to be careful to not go too far and install Mac OS and then also sign into your Apple ID or something like that. So you want to know when the right time to stop is. Now it's useful to review Apple's information about this before doing it. And one of the reasons is that there are a lot of variations depending upon which Mac you've got, which version of Mac OS that you currently have installed on it. And this changes all the time. So doing a tutorial here on exactly what to do isn't going to work, because some people will have a different situation, and over time that situation and some of the techniques may change. So this page at Apple site tells you basically what I just said. Create a backup. In other words, make sure you have everything you need off that computer. Then you want to sign out of things, like signing out of iTunes, signing out of iCloud, signing out of iMessage. And let's take a look at some of that right here. For instance, in the music app, which is what you would have normally now, not iTunes, you would go to account. And here I've got sign in, because this is my demo account. I'm not signed in, but you would see a sign out here. So you can sign out from the music app, and that should sign you out of the iTunes store. You also can go into things like the App Store, and in there, there's sign in and sign out. So you can sign out of that as well. In System Preferences, you can go to your Apple ID, and here you could also sign out. If you go to Overview, you can see here's the Sign Out button. So you can sign out of your Apple ID and iCloud account, which takes care of a lot of things. But you also want to continue to check other things. For instance, in the Messages app, there's also, under iMessage, a way to sign out. So you want to sign out of all those. Not a huge disaster if you don't, because you're going to erase the drive anyway, but it will make things a lot easier for you to sign out of all of these. Apple suggest for older Macs, Intel Macs, that you reset the Nvram. And if you click on this link here, it'll walk you through those steps. On newer Macs, you don't need to do that. But basically, it's rebooting, holding Option Command P and R down on those older Macs with Intel processors to clear Nvram. Unpairing Bluetooth devices is useful because sometimes Bluetooth devices can be stubborn. And if you leave them connected to a Mac that no longer exists, you don't have it anymore, and you've erased the hard drive, then getting that Bluetooth device to actually pair with something else can be troublesome. And then you want to erase your hard drive and reinstall Mac OS. So what you want to do is first shut down your Mac. Shut it down, and then you want to reboot it, but into recovery mode. To do that, what you're going to do is you're going to hold down the Command and R key. Now this is specific to the Intel processors. So if you have a newer Mac, there's a newer technique. Then you want to restart the Mac. And once you hear the chime, you can release your finger off of the power button, but you still want to hold down Command and R until you fully booted into recovery mode. Then you can release your fingers off those keys, let it finish booting into recovery mode, and your first order of business is to erase the hard drive. To do that, go into Disk Utility, and then this is where people get it wrong very often. You need to go into the View menu and you need to show all devices, because otherwise you're looking at just pieces of your hard drive and you can only erase each piece one at a time. You want to erase the entire hard drive, so you want to select the top level there like I have to erase the entire hard drive. Not doing this could leave pieces of your data behind and have basically a drive that's not formatted correctly. And then you might want to give it a name like Macintosh HD to be neat, and then go through these steps to erase the drive. Once you've done that and it's erased, it might take a while, then you'll be back here in recovery mode and you want to go to reinstall Mac OS. And when you reinstall Mac OS, you're going to walk through the prompts and select the drive to reinstall to. Now what this will do is it'll install everything just like it was a new Mac. You want to stop before you ever enter in your Apple ID or any information. So once it's finished installing, you basically are done and you do not want to continue as if this is going to be your Mac. So do not enter in any information that's yours, your Apple ID or anything. After it gets to that point into the install, simply shut down and your Mac is ready to give to somebody else. When they start it up, it will then show them the welcome screen and give them the opportunity to enter in their information. Back at this page here, you could see that Apple has specific instructions for erasing and reinstalling your drive. Notice that these steps, the ones I've gone through, are not for the newer Macs with Apple Silicon. You want to use a separate thing for that. Basically, you just hold the power button down and continue to hold it down until you get into the mode where you can choose options. So you could look here to see the steps for newer Macs. And you can see you end up at an options button there that you can then go and get into the same recovery mode there and go into Disk Utility to erase your Mac. Also, these pages have some troubleshooting tips here, and things change with each version of Mac OS. So you may want to review these pages before you go through the process and make sure you're making the choices that are correct for the Mac you have and the version of Mac OS that's installed.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.